Trucks, wake up!
Hello and welcome to the Lazy Talk podcast number 20.
He decides to open his chips or whatever, right, as we start the podcast.
Hey, you know, might as well get it started sooner or later. But yeah, me, Dreadcore, Old Trucks, Nightclub, Twisted,
Dreadcore, pay attention!
Wait, he's busy looking
the
new guys?
In the world.
What?
We got all the,
do we have almost everybody?
Yeah, almost everybody. We're missing Jake.
Jake? Really? Is that the only... Wow.
Yeah.
Everybody what? Give yourselves a hand.
Yeah.
Job.
All right.
What happened?
I feel like I'm the only one that did that. Okay. Everyone was actually just clapping. I was over here. All right.
Eric, well, you're handing yourself a hand job. All
more than one way to clap.
Yeah.
I guess that's how we get banned off YouTube.
Could you potentially post that? Just like, not show anything though?
You know, there's videos like that on YouTube, but they just aren't taken down yet. Like,
I remember there was a video of some guy like walking through the subway, like with his dick out, and it was on YouTube for like a month.
What in the world? Have you ever seen Cow Chop?
It was like, prank, got, like, bro. Prank!
Like, there's a video, like, they just like look up random videos. They find like a realistic, like, sex doll one. And that's in vivid detail.
Oh, yeah. I did see that.
Yeah. That's one example.
I don't know how they would allow that on YouTube. That's
That has,
else.
Like, so many views. Right, it's, like, 11 million views or something like
on
that.
On the Creature Hub, they had the videos with the what is it, Bad Dragon or whatever?
Well, that's just, that's not really, like, anything
they
serious.
Censored the Fleshlight, though, whenever it was on.
They did for some reason.
Hey, that's sexist. That is sexist.
Hey, you know, it is, yeah.
Free the nip.
Free the nip.
I love the, there was a, what's it called?
Has the podcast started yet? I'm
confused. Yes!
Yes!
Started. Okay.
I know, it's a magical.
I missed the intro.
It's called started and not started at the same time.
It's Schrodinger's like podcast. Meta.
Lacey's trying to start this for like half an hour.
It's meta. It's a meta podcast, guys.
It's a
Schrodinger's podcast.
So, Schrodinger's podcast.
Now, Schrodinger's would mean that it was in a box. Man. We wouldn't be able to perceive the podcast. We can perceive the podcast, therefore it's not Schrodinger's.
Fuck you.
I apologize for correctly.
The glitch in his name.
The glitch in the Matrix?
The glitch in the Matrix. Hmm? What's this picture?
What? That's what? Actually,
it's kind of funny.
Anyways, this podcast is one of those podcasts where we have almost everybody, and out of everybody here, almost everybody, Dreadcore, I think it's time you challenge somebody. Like, as one of us has previously stated before we just started, actually. A live challenge to
top koala. You need to get this top koala on a weekly schedule.
Please.
We probably should.
Yeah, it's been more like a monthly bit right now.
Yeah. Okay, well, okay, so I know Lays has been challenged.
You can't challenge me again.
It could be in Nightclub or Cody or Jake.
Well, Jake's not here. Nightclub, I challenge you to something!
Oh, shit.
That's it, Nightclub. Oh.
Challenge accepted.
Oh, fuck.
Wow.
Your soul is cursed!
It's on.
It's like we're going to play the game right now.
I don't know what game we're going to play, though.
I will figure it out later. I mean, I have no idea what we have in common.
Stay tuned.
We're not matching relationship profiles, man. We're just playing a game. I don't know what we got in common, man.
Yeah.
A matter of games we own. Did you ever release the top koala of you and Ultrox?
Yes.
It's been on for like a week.
Yeah. Okay. It's out there. I watched it. It was very amusing.
The truth is out there, guys.
It's us. You know.
Knuckle doesn't watch our videos. He's not a fan.
The truth is out there.
His phone name is described.
Yes, that one.
Yeah. Blah, 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 blah.
Like I said, I'm running like maybe 2 hours of sleep over the past several hours.
What did you do? What happened?
We had a lot of sex.
Stayed up all night at a gathering.
Yeah, I was gonna say, he probably didn't sleep.
Didn't sleep at all. Oh.
Yeah. Man, there is.
I slept for like an hour when I got home, but that was about it. It was by accident.
Do I not have a nightclub on?
You had an accident?
I had a nightclub on. Oh, there's nightclub. I just don't have it in the right category.
It does reach a point sometimes when you're staying up where, like, you don't become tired for a little bit.
Yeah, I'm not even really tired right now. I'm just kind of, my words.
Then you become tired very badly. So.
Yeah, it's just that my words and water and lack of thereof and soda and salts and tongue and dry and...
What? What are you
on? Yes.
He's saying
go
he's feel, he feels oh, shitty.
And three-headed chopsticks. And yeah.
Three-headed chopsticks.
What? Three-headed chopsticks.
A friend of mine at the party, he was, like, half asleep, and he was just, like, continuously coming in and out of a conversation through phases of, like, 5 minutes of sleep here and again. And I guess, like, some people were talking about Star Wars, and he suddenly brought up three-headed chopsticks.
Is that a reference? What?
Which would be one messed up fork, I guess.
Three-headed, I guess. I guess that'd be what it is.
And then Moon Jesus showed up, and then we talked about Moon the Rock Johnson.
Moon Jesus.
You guys ever played Towerfall Ascension?
No, I don't think so.
Then you would not understand Moon Jesus. Moon Jesus is praised.
You guys don't know Moon Jesus.
You guys don't know Moon Jesus like I know her.
Oh, you think God. You know Moon I'm Jesus?
Come on, no, goddess. No.
Cool.
So, okay. Like, whenever I, like, used to pull all-nighters sometimes, I would, like, be kind of sleepy, like, during the night hours. But during the day hours, I feel like I was on, like, cocaine, kind of.
That's kind of like, I'm not really... I'm not really tired.
Yeah.
I'm cocaine!
Mind might not all be there, but that's beside the point.
Yeah, like... But after, like, you know, about 36 hours or so, you start to feel tired again. And even worse, so.
I remember the first time we did that thing. It's called the Rockathon. Because initially,
Jimmy Johnson tapes.
Out like 4 years ago as a fundraiser where we would earn money by rocking and rocking chairs all night long. That eventually escalated into just a big old party.
Sounds like you could like develop like a bad habit from doing that. You start rocking during the day when you're in a regular chair.
Yeah, it for me, it lasted maybe about 6 hours, and then I was done. That's the first time. And it's
the whole podcast, by the way.
It's been less about the rocking and more about the thong in later years.
Thong?
A thong. Okay. Yes. And we played, like, watch movies, play video games all night. We played...
Is it even for charity anymore, though?
No, it's not. It's just for fun.
Oh, my. What the fuck?
And we stay up all night at the school, and it's amazing.
Man.
And yeah, this last night we like me and a bunch of my friends we played quite a few rounds of Secret Hitler.
Secret Hitler.
I won as Hitler, although we actually played with more than two fascists. With two fascists.
Oh my god!
I didn't know who they were, and I guess I was inadvertently working with them and. By the end of the game, I was working with them, but not even knowing who they were, because I was stupid.
Man,
you were stupid.
You guys ever played, like, all-nighters before?
Yeah.
Also, my teeth are probably really wrong.
Usually when I stay up all night, it's because I want to reset my sleep schedule, though.
Yeah, like, I used to do that sometimes. Now I just kind of give up.
I just gotta sleep whenever sleep needs sleep.
Yeah.
You know?
Like, whenever a plug TV was a thing, like, a long time ago, I would, watch a streamer called A Lucky, and, he did, like, I think, a 48-hour live stream, where he was gonna stay up the whole time. It was for charity, I think. I think. Could have been just a complete idiot, you know? But, yeah, I watched that guy for, like, a while. I stayed up. At some point, like, toward the end of it, I kinda, like, just immediately fainted.
What?
So, I woke up several hours later.
In a daze.
Yeah.
I'm feeling well rested.
Yeah. Woke up at like 4 p.m.
I hate that feeling though. Like, whenever you, like, you're doing something and the next thing you know, you're just you're awake with a weird taste in your mouth sometimes.
What? I think you're falling asleep in the wrong places.
Well, no, it's like you haven't anything to like eat or drink for a few hours without planning for it. I don't know. For me, it's like
I get what you're saying. Yeah.
Like for me, what if I'm like watching a movie, for instance, the next thing I know, I'm like, you know, falling asleep in my glasses, and I'm like, oh, what's happening? My lights are still on. I'm like, it's like 8 a.m. It's like, oh shit, I fell asleep. God damn it.
I
remember I stood up late all night once, and I think it was when I didn't have any internet, which is not a good idea because, you know, you pass the time by sleeping.
Yeah.
But
what did you do with sleep time?
And I just played video games all night long, and I think the first game I played BioShock Infinite, and I finally beat it.
Oh wow!
This was like years ago.
I'll tell you, man. No internet, you get productive.
And then by the end of the night, I was playing Transformers 4 for Cybertron. Is that the first one?
Yes.
And I beat the entire game, and I had no fucking clue what was going on the entire time. I was in such like a sleepless daze.
I think I just played a game, but I could have been raped. I don't know.
All I remember was there was like this jet level where you're going around shooting people. That's all I remember. But I beat the game, apparently.
I've done that. You remember that time we were playing Destiny and that kind of happened to me?
Yeah.
Yeah, we were playing like levels in one of the new DLCs, or the DLCs of new at the time. And we were playing through the levels, and I was literally half asleep when we were doing those. And I was dying, and I had no idea what was going on.
Did we defeat the darkness yet?
Pretty much.
Yep. So,
I think there was one part where he just kind of fell asleep a little bit. And then he came back to.
Yeah, I'm good right now.
So don't stay up without sleep playing video games. That's the moral of the story.
Yeah.
Well, but I do that every year.
Okay. I do that every year.
Thanks, Cody. Thanks. All right,
well. See.
Okay.
Yeah. Man.
Filled some time there.
Yeah.
Hey. Hey, you guys want to see something cool?
Okay. That was dun, unplanned.
Dun,
dun. Dun, dun, dun.
He's a Mexican.
First thing lays his mouth.
Of course
dun,
that was
dun, your... dun. He's a Mexican. Okay.
No one expected
it. Nightclub.
So probably not a Bernie voter. Or a Trump voter.
Yeah.
Okay. Someone voter.
What?
He doesn't vote for people.
He doesn't vote for anyone. He's illegal.
Vote for me.
Oh!
Okay.
Guys, vote me for president.
Nice to finally meet you, Nightclub.
Yeah, nice to see you guys too.
Did we ever say why I'm on the floor? Was that said during the podcast?
No.
You are.
No one ever noticed.
Of course. You even noticed.
No one
ever noticed.
You're renovating your room, is what you're doing, right?
Yes. Yes, room is being renovated.
You guys ever notice how I'm wearing jeans today?
I'm not.
Yeah, we definitely noticed that, you know. From your face cam.
It's like those Spider-Man thing. Oh, wow, look at that. He's wearing Deadpool. Oh, look at my teeth.
He's wearing Deadpool.
Represent.
Represent.
Gotta
represent. I'm representing. This.
I represent myself.
This color.
Alright, well.
I represent the Imperium of Man.
Do you, though?
I don't think me and Nightclub ever really explained why we wore masks in the first place.
I just thought of wearing them.
Well, why? I wanna
it was mostly random, just.
Okay.
Like, you know. You guys didn't know what we looked like, and we wanted to keep that up or something.
Yeah.
But also, when we were back in the Dead Fet Productaducts, we had a plan that if we kept going, then if we ever did face or like, not face cam, but live stuff, we would be wearing Jango Fett Deadpool masks. But it never got that far.
Obviously. So.
But now that's over.
Excuse me.
Yeah, that face is gone.
The face is
ten. That phase. I said phase,
oh,
not
phase.
Phase.
Just the face, honey. He's wearing that mask for a reason.
Yeah. Now, if you want my next face reveal, what's behind the skin. And,
I'm a skeleton.
You guys will have to get me a knife and some plastic, some surgery ready. Or at least a hospital.
We're going to start a Kickstarter for that.
Surgery. Something like that.
We can start a Kickstarter for anything these days.
Yeah. If we had to start a Kickstarter right now, what would it be? I think it would be to have Dreadcore, like, a dedicated personal tutor to reject his alcoholism.
I was just gonna say putting Dreadcore in a homeless shelter.
Really? Is that what you need a Kickstarter for? To take money away from him?
Hire someone to mug me.
GoFundMe or something. I don't think it's that, but
it wouldn't just be mugging me. It'd be burning down my current house and getting me kicked out of my current jobs. Be all of that. Then I would probably go to a homeless shelter. That'd be a lot of money. All that.
Place for, like, pay for, like, medical bills and stuff. Yeah. And put them up there.
Couple hundred.
There you go.
Well, no, we'd have to go up to Delaware, so probably be
buy Dreadcore a new desk.
Buy me a house.
Dreadcore spent all his money on Stellaris, on video games.
Yeah, all of it.
Actually, I bought him Stellaris.
He had to sell his desk.
Cody did buy him Stellaris.
Cody did buy me Stellaris. That's pretty
awesome. That's very sweet.
Man, so
you guys, like, peek out when you're, like, in a bit, like, calls of playing Stellaris.
What?
You guys, like, make out.
No.
He's, like, experiment a little bit.
No, he's not my type.
What a random thing to say.
Why is that your question?
I'm just curious.
Yeah, I'm curious.
Stop being so curious.
What in the world?
Curiosity. Yeah.
God.
What does your shirt say? I'm a bacon.
I am a bacon patriot.
Patriot.
Oh, I see. It's a flag.
Mm-hmm.
What's the star mean? Like, what's on the star?
Oh, right. That's bacon. On this one. This is right.
Just
it's a brand. Bacon.
Rant.
Right.
Steve Harvey Bacon?
G-H-C, no.
Steve Harvey
it's
Bacon?
It's Right Bacon. It's Right Bacon, not Steve Harvey Bacon. It's Right Bacon.
We need to get some
Steve
Harvey
Bacon.
We need to be sponsored by Steve Harvey at some point.
There's some over...
We haven't mentioned Steve Harvey in a bit, though, so he's forgotten about us.
Yeah.
Forgotten about us.
We haven't talked about him in our... Very.
You need to make sure to mention Steve Harvey in every
every episode, at least twice.
To Steve Harvey, this podcast, and then you know.
Harvey.
So
Harvey of the Steve.
Like that episode of You Don't Know Jack with Paul Rudd everywhere.
What? Paul Rudd?
And You Don't Know Jack.
Oh yeah.
Jack Plus 40 Pack. One of the episodes of it. Most of the questions are Paul Rudd themed.
Wow, what a interesting category.
I didn't know Paul Rudd was that popular.
Man.
Paul Rudd.
I guess so. He's probably going to get more popular in recent years, times. Yeah. Kind of like Tom Holland's going to be popular because he's Spider-Man.
That's a spoiler.
Is it?
Captain America Silk. No, it's not.
Everyone knows by this point. If they don't, then you're a scrub.
My club's the only one who's seen Civil War.
I haven't seen it yet. Soon. Soon. I will.
All you need to know is that it's good. It's really good. I love it.
What did you go to see recently, Lays?
I went to see Keanu.
That's right. Oh,
you saw Keanu before you saw Civil War.
Priorities. But it was
What was the decision making? That one.
Well, Keanu, it was the last day it was going to be in my theater, so I had to go watch it. Civil War still's got, like, another week or so, so I'm good there.
It's going to stay in theater 2 years.
Probably. But yeah, Keanu. Oh, my God. Keanu, that is the cutest.
I got a question first.
Okay.
Have you actually seen John Wick, though?
No.
Oh, my God. I feel like you should probably see John Wick if you want to see that movie
a little bit. It's good by itself, but, you know, I feel like there is some, like, crossover.
You'd understand the reference a bit more.
Yeah.
In which case, no.
But man, that cat is really cute. It's interesting to say the least.
I should go get a kitten to show during the podcast. I actually have one.
Is it yours?
No.
Yeah, we'll finally get those female views.
Oh, yeah.
Should I go get one right now?
Yeah, sure, why not?
Why not?
I guess, okay.
He's gonna go get some, catch some pussy.
We're gonna get
yes.
the view.
Pussy
cats. Man, so, what kind of cat do you think he's bringing? I think he's gonna bring in a black and white cat.
I don't know. It's gonna be a cat with the Deadpool mask.
It's gonna be a Deadpool mask on it. Wow. If that happens,
he waits 4 or 5 months to reveal its face.
Yeah.
Once a full-grown cat.
All right, guys, we're going to have the cat face reveal.
My back. Why does it hurt?
Because you're old, man.
Oh, I think he's back.
It's so precious.
Not that old.
Here he is. Oh, the cat. Oh, dang, it's not black
and
white.
Oh, shit, it's a kitten.
Oh, that's just adorable.
Hey, it's Keanu.
It's Keanu.
This is Keanu, star of the hit film Keanu.
Wow. Oh, look at
Keanu
him.
Keanu.
Oh, look at him. Oh, he's too cute. Please.
Oh, come on.
Oh, put him to the... Oh, yeah. Oh!
Oh!
Oh, man.
It made cute noises.
Oh, God. Man.
Star of the hit film Keanu.
Man.
Oh, Keanu, how'd you like working with J.J. Abrams?
Give him a little meow.
Give him a meow. Give him a meow.
He doesn't want to get away from me.
He doesn't like you.
He's clingy.
Okay, fine. Okay.
Are you just going to have that kitty now for the podcast?
No, I should go put him back. He doesn't like it.
Oh, come on.
Goodbye, kitty.
No.
Give him a little meow.
Do like the Lion King.
I think you have him backwards.
Sorry. Oh, I'm sorry. Okay.
Okay.
You keep going on.
Oh, wow. What in the world? Wow.
I did that once with one of their older puppies. Kind of did a little Lion King bit.
What kind of dog was it?
What dog was it again?
Ask
him when he gets. He'll remember. Their old dogs had like a litter of puppies at one point a few years back, and they had like a whole bunch of puppies. Unfortunately, I think I wasn't around when it happened, but like one of them had died by drowning in a bucket.
Oh my! Did you do that one?
No.
Okay. Drowning in a bucket.
It was an accident, I swear.
So bad. No. Okay. But moving on. But no. Like, I remember there was also this one puppy. I don't know what her name is right now by her owners, but what they had called her at the time was Captain Falcon.
Captain Falcon.
Yeah. And
good old Captain Falcon. He was a great dog.
Yeah, and she was my favorite personally. I don't know why. She's just cute. But, yeah, I remember like one time. There's like this mattress that was on the ground in the living room of Ultrox's old house, and I placed the puppy on there, and the puppy went through the extra effort of like crawling off of the mattress. It was so adorable to watch. But as soon as she did that, she literally just took a shit on the ground.
Yeah, I remember this story.
Oh, hey, you're okay, don't you?
What in the world?
Hey, see
my
nice
dog
carpet?
From
yeah,
that.
Yeah, fuck that carpet.
What? Oh, yeah. That's
carpet.
Okay.
Fuck that carpet.
It's going over my head.
Fuck that carpet. Yeah, fuck that.
I actually still have a dog from that litter. She's been in the podcast. She's in the background.
Yeah, her name is Sweet Tart.
She's an idiot.
Yeah. Was there a time, a period of time where she would literally like put half of herself up on a, like a couch or something and makes the you like bring her legs
she's
up?
She's lazy as fuck.
Wait, like she put her legs on the couch, like just stand on her like front paws while like, she's sitting down.
She's like waits for you to lift her legs back up onto the bed for it.
She's lazy. Does she still do that?
Yeah, occasionally.
Yeah. She sounded so deflated, like, yeah, just resigned to it. Yeah, she does.
What a dumb bitch.
Well, I mean,
Jesus.
Not wrong.
Not wrong, you know.
Oh. It's gonna be the cutest episode of the podcast ever. You need to put that cat in the thumbnail, get us some extra views.
Yeah. Oh man.
Dreadcore, you look sad!
Oh, Dreadcore.
What are you reading up anyway, Dreadcore? What do you do during the podcast?
What do I do during the podcast? I listen to you guys.
What else?
Also, a minute ago, I was doing some weird hand motions and dancing and mock fighting.
I saw that
shit
when I came in.
Yeah.
You guys just ignored me.
I saw it. I was doing some stuff. I was doing like a little bit of this.
I was telling the story about a dog shitting on the ground. I was paying attention.
Yeah, man, pay attention. It's going to be on the quiz.
Sam's too busy talking about a shitting dog.
It's a load of bullshit.
It's dog shit. It's dog shit.
It's dog shit, really. Oh,
there you go. Yeah. Man, so
puppy shit, puppy poop,
puppy,
puppy papa,
damn you, so, puppy.
You guys ever have any other pets?
I got a black German Shepherd.
Do you have it now?
I have a corgi beagle mix.
Wait, what?
I have a corgi beagle mix.
You are, or you have?
I have. Do I look like a dog to you?
I mean, I don't want to be racist, but...
Woof, motherfucker!
There you go, it's confirmed. He's the corgi beagle mix.
Yeah, her name is Angel.
Angel, wow.
She is... You've probably heard her barking in the podcast before.
Yeah, probably. Or videos in general.
Cody has a bird.
Cody has a bird and a cat. And probably other animals, I think.
And four dogs.
And four dogs. Man.
I had two chinchillas.
Oh,
what happened?
I gave them. I when I moved to my old apartment. hold on. When I moved to my old apartment, I couldn't have pets.
Okay.
So at all, like even small rodents. So I found a friend of mine. She is this large
YouTuber.
Large Czechoslovakian woman.
Large.
Okay.
Large Czechoslovakian woman, and
Czech women are hot.
And this is where I put up a picture of like the most ugly woman I could find.
Oh, here, obviously. iPhone.
Yeah. Ah! Czech flag. Oh.
He's looking up Czech women.
Yeah. Oh.
Oh, my girlfriend texted me.
Oh, wow. We know he has a girlfriend.
And she's Czech.
And she's Czech.
Okay, yeah.
She's in Czech.
It's actually Twisted's friend.
She's Czech.
She just sent me a meow with a question mark. Meow?
Is she watching this?
Oh, she's watching the podcast.
Oh, really?
No, she's not. I've shown her clips from podcasts, though. Like that like that time when I did the pelvic thrust, she enjoyed that, you could say.
Oh, she...
Nice.
Enjoyed I will speak no more on this matter. Anyways. Here's a Lego motorcycle. For your viewing
thing to show. Here's a Lego motorcycle.
Chinchillas or something?
Give me it now.
Wait, what were you saying?
You're talking about your chinchillas?
Yeah, no, I had two chinchillas, and I gave them to a Czechoslovakian woman because she loved them.
Okay.
That's all I'm saying. It's just I had
these. Yeah,
it's possible that
she... No. Actually, let me tell you how I got them. That's a more interesting story, actually.
Okay.
So, I drive for a living, so I'm gone most of the time, and my girlfriend was like, you know, I want a dog or something. Well, the apartment before the last apartment, we couldn't have dogs or larger animals. So what we ended up doing was saying, I made a joke, said, hey, we can get a couple of chinchillas, knowing my girlfriend's usually kind of a Jew about things, so didn't think she'd want to spend a lot of money. I was wrong. She wanted not one, but two of these little furry bastards, and they're about $400 each.
Whoa, what?
It's expensive.
Let me look up a picture of a chinchilla right now.
That's going to cost you like $20.
Oh, they're
cute
as hell, but they're some of the most antisocial creatures you will ever meet.
Man.
They didn't want shit at all to do with anybody but themselves.
What the fuck?
You know?
Hey, look at them.
I want to see this.
Basically, they get the softest thing you've ever touched.
Okay.
And they're softer.
I don't know. That kitten was pretty soft.
No, if you ever felt chinchilla, you'd be like, I everything else is dull to me now. I can't feel anything else.
Even pure cotton.
Yeah.
Light.
Wow. No, yeah. Look, I said this in class one day, and it's kind of shocked people. I used to live in Mississippi when I was younger.
Okay.
And I asked people, hey, have y'all ever gone cotton diving before? And these people looked at me like I was fucking crazy. I'm like, what? You've never been cotton diving before? And literally what cotton diving was literally when they freshly pick cotton, those big bales.
Yeah.
You just hop in and it's just like jumping on a cloud. It's amazing.
Millennium Falcon is back there somewhere.
Well, you can't jump on a cloud, you just fall right through.
It's like how you imagine jumping on a cloud would feel like.
Like jumping on a cloud in a cartoon.
I do want to see the Storm of Shepherd, though, that you have. I never knew you had
She is in the kennel, and she is a pain in the ass.
Oh.
She is a dumbass.
I could bring my dog in for a brief moment.
What, is this ever going to be called, like, pets or something? Koalas, pets?
Sure. Show and tell. Pets.
A lot of pets going on here.
I knew someone in second grade that had Mexican flying squirrels as pets.
Nightclub?
Interesting.
Wasn't nightclub squirrel?
Sure.
What made the squirrel Mexican?
It was born in Mexico, obviously.
Was it wearing a sombrero and trying to sell oranges? What made it Mexican?
Yeah.
Do Mexicans sell oranges?
Yes, in Florida they do.
There you go.
Normal Mexicans. Like if they live in Mexico, do they sell oranges?
Some of them probably do.
Yeah, probably.
Someone
this is all I know to sell them the orange fruits.
Like
to the unsuspecting American kids.
That sombrero and like a little mustache, like that mouse. I forget the name. There's a mouse, cartoon mouse that has sombrero. All
right, Speedy Gonzales.
Yes.
Yeah.
Squirrely Gonzales.
Speedy Gonzales.
No, I mean, but this is Squirrely Gonzales.
She's not the lightest thing, but here she is.
Oh wow, a dog. Oh.
It's a doggy.
Is that the one that pooped?
The doggy's like,
what am I doing? Who are these people? What the fuck? Mother said your mask could never be off.
Look at him confused. Let's give him a voice. Let's make him like this is saying stuff.
This is Angel. She's my Beagle Corgi mix.
Oh, wow.
She isn't always an angel, and she has a foot fetish.
Oh.
Ah!
Don't say that.
She does. She's embarrassed.
Oh.
I'm sorry, Angel. I didn't mean it. I'm sorry. Okay. Love me.
She's like cylindrical shaped. It's very impressive.
She's also very just confused.
Also, the way I have her sitting right here, she actually can do that on her own when she's on the ground.
She can. It's impressive.
Yeah. And she likes licking a lot. She's also a herding dog, so she'll nip at your feet a bit, especially when you have shoes on. And she loves biting gloves. Never wear gloves around her. Okay. She's done.
She's done. She's
done. Let me open the door for her.
Mm-hmm. Time to take her out in the yard.
All right, let's see. Hang on.
All right,
there
like,
she is.
Shoot her
as
like
a puppy.
Old Yeller.
Is that a German Shepherd?
Oh,
yeah, German Shepherd. That's her, the puppy.
Oh, looks like a.
German Shepherds' ears aren't poked up when they're young.
So yeah.
My dad was like looking at it like that's not a German Shepherd. It's a German Shepherd. Both his parents are German Shepherds. It's a German Shepherd.
But the grand.
So, if you ever hear the barking in the background of like my videos or from my end of things, you'll know what it looks like now.
Foot fetish dog. Okay. Well, are you looking at more pictures, Twisted?
Yeah, I'm trying to find.
Okay. Well, in the meantime, like my family's stolen like several dogs before. Also, a hamster that died.
Fuck!
Oh, yeah.
It's a picture of a chinchilla drinking out of a Starbucks cup.
What? Is chinchillas? I'm gonna put that picture in the podcast. Let's see. Well, I used to have like a hamster, and like we took it to like a contest.
See, it's right there.
Thanks.
Oh.
Wow, that's kind of cute. Let's see. Oh wow. I think they're a really big hamster or a very small cup.
Very small cup.
Very small cup. That's a chinchilla.
Yeah.
It is a chinchilla.
Man. So, like, we used to have, like, a hamster called Speedy. Like, whenever,
it's
like,
still
I was, like,
a very small cup,
maybe 10. Oh, is that?
Oops. My God.
What am I looking at right now?
That is my German Shepherd.
Oh, it looks like cleavage.
She has a sweater on right now.
Barely.
Oh, I see the dog now. Okay.
But she is, like, pitch black.
You see the dog now.
On her chest is a patch of white that has the shape of a heart.
Oh, wow. That's adorable, it sounds like.
Yeah.
Man.
But I would bring her in, but she is a hell. I think she's hit her head too many times on our coffee table.
My word.
Is that dog mentally retarded?
I think so. I really think so.
God, it's like...
I hate
like
with, that guy, but I really think the dog's... There's something wrong with her.
It's like with loose dogs.
Dogs and objects don't mix well.
Do you guys remember loose dogs?
Oh, I do. Yeah.
And that's the I guess.
One or whatever.
It was like one was a deaf... I think one was blind too. I think.
A friend of mine owns a golden retriever that's named Zeus.
Zeus.
Yeah. I actually haven't met him. I've seen pictures of him, and I think I saw him once.
Your friend or
in,
Zeus?
I don't think he exists.
He does.
I made him up.
Oh, he doesn't.
Friend. It's okay.
Well, we know his name now.
Yeah. He was choosing between the names of Zeus or Hercules, and I would said Hercules because Zeus is a dick.
Wow.
Calm down.
Do you
know him personally?
Zeus,
and then he chose the other just to spite you.
Also, Zeus does fit better. It's, you know, comes off the tongue easier.
That's why you have.
It's all three.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's not as hard for the dog to remember.
Hercules is the name of the.
Same hot dog.
The. Yes, it's also the name of the. The guy from Pit the... Boss, the little person. His dog is named Hercules. Everybody look up Pit Boss. It's a great show.
Alright.
Well, Boss Hercules.
Is that the one with the midgets?
I said little people, but that works too.
Well,
nah, midget sounds better.
Alright.
It's a great show, I tell you what.
Oh, look at that! There's Hercules!
One of these days, I'll be able to talk.
It's there, in the show, there.
He's a pit bull.
He's a pit bull.
They're pit bull rescuers, but also they're actors, and so they're always trying to get acting jobs where they're like not elves and stuff. It's really sad.
Oh yeah, I can see that being a thing. Yeah.
Yeah, if you're a little
Peter
person,
Dinklage
that would fucking suck. Yeah.
Hey.
Into the mainstream.
I mean, Peter Dinklage got the part as the Great Eagle and Angry Birds, so
he got the part of the boss and elf man.
He's still a little person. I know. Fucking Angry Birds movie. My God.
Man.
That came out Friday, didn't it?
It's
Saturday,
out now,
right?
Yeah, it's out. It's out, yeah. I don't know when, but it is
out. It came out. It's Saturday, right?
It is Saturday, yes.
Saturday, yes.
The concept of time is mixed up now because of the all-nighter I pulled. But...
Okay.
I felt like something for a moment.
So this is my dog, Jackson, I had like a while back from 4 years ago.
Oh.
Look at that.
That's a darn sure dog. Up.
Yeah. His name was Jackson.
Like
Michael Jackson. Named after Michael Jackson?
I mean...
I love Michael Jackson.
Hey, you know,
that little child diddler.
Yeah.
What?
He's probably like my top five pedophile.
Allegedly.
Why do you have a top five list?
There's Jared. Michael. He's up there too, you know. He's inspirational.
Jared's
you know?
Pretty good.
Inspirational!
Yeah.
Ah!
Ah!
Like, ah!
Reset.
Why? Why did you do that?
Back to,
do the noise!
Why'd you do the noise?
Which noise?
Yeah.
Let's get this podcast back on track, guys.
Yes.
We had a track.
All tracks. When has this podcast ever been on track?
Well, before you guys started talking.
No, it was never on track.
There was a topic we're talking about next.
It wasn't even a track.
Yeah, no thanks to you, Dreadcore.
Let's see. Well, so, my family used to have a lot of pets back in the day. And we had a hamster called Speedy. He was a fast little bitch.
Oh, gee.
Like, we took him to, like, the mall for, like, a contest. He won first place. I think shortly after he died, because my mom probably killed him.
Oh.
Like, good old vacuum cleaner. Oh, yeah!
Go 2016!
I think a vacuum cleaner was involved. if we were playing the game Clue, I'd probably match it, you know, pretty head on there. But yeah, speed and tight.
Cross point sustained, guys. Yeah, we did it. We're almost there.
Ooh. That's all I have to say about that. All right.
I'm trying to make a hint here.
Yeah. Oh, hey. Lace was in the middle of his story when you're trying to make a hint.
Yeah.
I know. I was trying to divert from that tragic story of a vacuum cleaner and his dead dog thing.
Dead dog.
It was a dead hamster, but whatever.
Yeah, dogs. The poor dog got vacuumed up in there.
Imagine!
That's really sad.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, hey, guys, original thought here. But three of us are graduating this year.
Oh, shit.
Wow.
I graduated 4 or 5 years ago.
In fact, my class ring is in my my other room, but I'm not going to show it because it has my name on it.
It's the ring.
It's the ring. So it's going to be me, Old Trucks, and Nightclub. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, me and Dreadcore already kind of graduated.
Yeah.
And Cody, I think.
I love the word Dreadcore is.
So, hold on. I don't know if anybody saw this. Like, Dreadcore's glasses just did that weird anime thing. What? He touched them and they fucking lit up.
What? He pulled some crazy
because of the screen.
I need
Lays, you need to go back and edit in like the noise they make. Whatever. Don't they make a noise in anime sometimes?
Yes, it's like a glinting noise.
Lays, you need to go back and edit that in. All right, look at your timer and see what time it's at.
Yeah, they like push the smart kids like push their glasses up and then they say something and then it's like,
No, like this. You gotta push it up like this. Is that with middle finger? Yeah, like that. Yeah.
I think someone did it with the index.
So,
I mean, it's
anyways. Yeah. Did you guys, like, have a senior quote at all?
I do.
Really?
No, I wasn't even in my yearbook.
You weren't even in it?
No.
Did you ask them not to put you in it?
Like, yes.
Okay. Well, there you go.
I did not go to, like, the graduation thing. What is it when you're, like... Isn't there, like, what is it you do? It's like a little, what?
Ceremony?
Yeah, I didn't go to that.
Hey, Cody.
Oh, I got a story about my graduation. It was kind of cool.
Yeah?
It was like that almost, but what happened was we were all in the big stadium field we have in our town.
Mm-hmm.
And basically, it started raining. It started raining out the graduation. Well, me and a bunch of buddies were like, you know, we're not letting it stop us. They try to stop the graduation, and me, Samuel, and Alex, and a couple other dudes.
Samuel.
But we walked the entire graduating class back out into the field.
Oh, wow.
Just to get turned around and told us we can't do that.
Wow.
And then
surprise.
They canceled it. We ended up going to Waffle House to eat dinner.
To graduate?
They dismissed everyone. So we're like, fine, but nobody told us.
Instead of handing you a diploma, they start handing you waffles.
This is close enough.
Here's your diploma, here's your waffle. Here's your diploma, here's your waffle. Still got a strawberry dressing on top? Well, too bad. You should have done better in school.
You want a pecan or chocolate chip waffle?
So yeah, but my senior quote is... I am convinced that life is 10% what happens to me and 90% of how I react to it.
I think that's the one that's
inspirational.
This is a variation of that quote. I think it's like 10% what happens to you and 90% of how you react to it. More of a second person kind of way of saying it, but you get the idea.
Yeah.
Point of pretty per skint.
Yeah. But no, I remember I initially heard that when I was at my community college when we were doing a little initiation thing.
Yeah.
And it was one of the quotes that we had to collect around the campus, and I remember seeing that quote and I'm like, that was I like this, I should use this as my senior quote.
And there you go.
And, you know,
that is
I so, didn't hey, Lays, have a senior quote.
Okay. Lays,
there
we
was
spent
none.
3 hours trying to win one solo one match of Sky Wars. I just won one.
Oh my god!
Sorry, we couldn't win anything, and then I just win off the bat like, okay.
Well, for context, what is this it? Was streaming Minecraft earlier.
What game is it?
Skywars. Is that like Star
Wars?
It's like Star Wars, except it's in the sky, not in the stars. Yeah, and instead of lightsabers,
Star Wars Battlefront, there's no space battles, so it's all.
You should rename it to
Sky Wars.
Sky Wars, Wars, guys.
Infinite Warfare has space combat of some kind.
No, don't talk about that.
Don't talk about Advanced Warfare 3. Okay.
Okay. Well, my quote for my senior quote was. I'm always first, even in yearbooks. That's funny, because I'm the first person in the yearbook.
I wonder why.
Oh, yeah, last names, gotcha.
Yep, starts with AD, hard to beat that. Well,
it's pretty cool.
Yeah.
I was trying to think, last names, yeah, gotcha.
It's not really a secret, we can say it, but...
Adkins.
Okay, there you go.
Josh Adkins.
Middle name.
Like Tress Atkins, but not as gay in country.
Man, so...
This is the first year that my high school actually had yearbooks,
Really?
Surprised.
Yeah, his school is weird. It has a weird system. Don't they have, like, the thing where, like, the first Wednesday of every month
is... Yeah, there's no school on the first Wednesday for some reason.
Why is that a thing?
There's no reason to it.
No reason to it at all. It's just because it's arbitrary.
I wouldn't argue with it, but hey, you know, why?
And then there are just sometimes where they have Fridays off for no reason apparently, and I'm just I'm sitting here thinking to myself, what the fuck is wrong with your school?
I barely go. There's like barely any days you have to go. Barely.
Man,
I had to go like 2 days there.
2 days.
2 days a week.
Do you not have to go to there like on a daily basis?
Well, I've had all of my classes done for a while, so I haven't needed to go in there at all. But
at least nearly 2 months, I think, actually now, isn't it?
My school not that at all.
Like he was done.
I've had all my credits done, so I haven't needed to go in there.
Yeah, he's been done since like the beginning of April.
The beginning.
Are we gonna play a game after this?
Maybe.
But I was going to say that I would have had at least 2 great quotes to be able to put in there.
Yeah, 2. But he didn't have a book to put on that.
The one I would probably put in there is Perfection is Boring, because that was the title of my editing series.
Oh my god.
Perfection is
like
boring!
Like, promotion, like, subscribe to me on YouTube.
Or, alternatively, no one would understand it, or they just think I'm a weirdo, if I could rearrange the alphabet of P and I together.
Oh my god.
They think it'd be like, wow, who's that meant for? Man, but yeah.
Who's this guy trying to pick up?
It's a shameless plug, guys, and you, like, put a link to your YouTube channel.
It's like a
channel.
QR code. What if you had like a QR code like on your shirt, like for like the picture? Oh man, that'd been awesome. I wish I did that now. That'd be cool.
Oh Trump, you should have taken your senior pictures with your Dead Fed hoodie in it.
Oh, totes.
Oh yeah, I wore this. Oh wow, you got a hoodie with Dead Fed on it? Oh wow.
Cougars.
Oh
look at that. Yeah, no,
I don't know what that is, but it's a Washington State thing.
Oh okay. The Washington State thing with Cougars. I see.
Man. Oh, it also relates to my dream. That's right.
Wow, it's all coming together.
Interwebs.
Wow. It's a big circle.
It's happening.
It's a big circle.
Let's go. Is Michael's webcam frozen for anyone? I need to take a picture.
It is for me. Yeah, I just see like a bunch of like the circle going around.
His webcam's gone. Oh,
he's making a kissy face for me. All
right. Well.
Yeah, he's making a kissy face. So I'm gonna save it as a picture.
Okay. Alright, I need to use the bathroom, and since the makeup's also not here, I'm gonna go right back. Go pee.
What the fuck?
What are you doing?
Alright, I'm gonna be right back.
Like, can't you tell? I'm building a house.
Okay.
Guess so! Right. Oh shit, my camera. It's not on. No.
Hopefully that lines up. Hurry, we need to make this as entertaining as possible so that he doesn't cut it out.
Yeah.
Let me make a gif of that.
Ow.
Going at 2 frames a second.
Ow.
Or not.
I don't want.
Guys, we need 110% participation.
My God, you guys
Everyone
are like suckers.
As much as possible.
I am the 110%.
Lace! You suck donkey dicks!
Lace is the worst person I've ever met. He's a real asshole.
He makes
I
children
cry. I am the worst person you've ever met.
In his sleep! He makes Cody cry in his sleep!
No, no.
He ought to!
No.
More like looking at him makes Cody cry in his sleep because he's a butterface. I don't know. Wait, yeah, did that even make it into the podcast?
Does your face hurt? Because it hurt. My eye has hurt seeing it. What does it help you?
Okay. Yeah, I don't
know. What the fuck was that?
A piano?
And of course, an organist.
Dun dun dun.
Dun 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 dun.
Be quiet. He's coming back.
Ow! What the fuck? No one saw that.
No one saw it, guys.
Making it into the podcast right here.
So,
does your face hurt?
A little. No. Why would you say that, Cody? Nothing happened.
It's killing me.
Let's see.
Oh, snap.
So, you guys got anything else to talk about? Or do you want to just, like, start, like, ending the podcast, like, with a segment?
Dreams of Swampy Daddy. That's been on my topic for a while now.
Has it?
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure. It's, okay, well, yeah, we'll talk about it. Let's go.
Okay, well, how it goes is...
Okay.
What was the context? It was a dream.
Yeah.
Don't drop this. I just had this weird dream one time where I was staying up late one night because it was spring break at my high school, mm-hmm. not my community college though, and I was I had gone to bed at like 2 a.m. and I just had this random dream where I dreamt I was late for my class at my college and I got up really, you know, fast and sporadically, and as I got up, like, I walked out to my living room, and for some reason, like, there's just these, like, Christmas decorations out.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, there's just a bunch of Christmas shit out, like, my mom had decorated for Christmas or something, and then, you know, they were in the way of the door, so I had to move them out of the way, along with everything else I had to do to get ready for, you know, school, so I was late as it was, and that made it worse. And then, when I went outside, the entire area property of my house was like a swamp area type place. Like, my mom had like put a bunch of swamp stuff and alligators were going around.
What?
Yeah, it was like a swamp. I don't know how. Wait, I live in the desert.
Wait, what? She put alligators.
What are you doing in my
around?
Swamp?
Yeah, it's like, and I don't know. There were alligators. There was some kind of weird creature that was crawling around, and I was, yeah, and, but the
worm.
Yeah, but like, but I that aside, I walk up to my car, and as I'm walking to my car, in my dream, my dad is sitting in the car, like waiting for me, pointing at his wrist, like he knows I was gonna be late. But the kicker is, my dad, for the fuck, I don't know why, but
your dad died 30 years ago.
I am in the car. My dad was sitting in the car. Butt-ass naked.
Come on, son. We gotta go. We gotta go, son. Come on.
Bullshit like that. And, like, there's, like, a bunch of, like, water and stuff in the seats and in the floors of the car, like, some of the swamp water I'd gotten in. So I kicked my dad out. You know, he's still naked. And I was avoiding those creatures, so I wouldn't kill them because I didn't want to do that.
So kind and peaceful.
And then I wake up And I'm like, what the fuck just happened? And I looked down at my clock, and an hour had gone by.
That's the only reasonable thing to say after you wake up.
An hour and a half, it was only an hour and a half that had passed. I thought it was like a whole night's worth. It was only an hour and a half of sleeping.
What in the world?
Creeps. All hell. Daddy. Yeah, I called Dreams of Swampy that.
Oh my god.
Dreams of Swampy.
Man, how about this other one you got there? Called working on recording videos for personal channels.
Yes, I mean, this was more so like a month ago, but okay. I was recording videos for my channel. I haven't uploaded them yet because I want to get something to better process them, I guess, suppose, edit them. But, yeah, I recently started recording a series for Valkyria Chronicles.
What's that game?
I heard of it.
Yeah. Like I got that in one of the recent Humble Bundle.
Shout out to the Humble Bundle.
Stop sniffing! God damn it!
I'm not sniffing, I'm blowing.
Stop blowing!
He's blowing.
But yeah, so I have six to be able to record on that. Hold on, it's in my file somewhere. Videos, captures.
Now, are you at all concerned that you will never upload these videos?
I will.
It happens.
Yeah, I mean, it'll happen eventually. You know, here's like, I don't know if you guys can hear this. Wait for it.
Oh, hello? I heard that. Enhance that.
Enhance.
Enhance again.
Ow.
Wait, look in the reflection.
It's like that. It's
like a
Futurama thing.
Yeah. So, but you guys will be able
to, forehead.
But you guys will eventually be able to see that when I upload them on my channel in full everything, and it's fun. Although I had to re-record the first episode because my recording like it stopped recording my voice like halfway through, so it's a pain in the ass. You know, hey, that's the way it goes sometimes, right, guys? That's
the way it goes.
Okay, I wanted to do one thing before we do something to kick this off.
All right.
I wanted to show off my Miitomo.
You have a Miitomo?
Oh, no. No.
Nine.
What?
Nice. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Nine.
Bonuses.
Voltrox is literally Hitler.
Nine.
Oh, oops. I gotta get this started again.
Nine, brother.
Oh, it's Lays.
Hey, I'm coming over, guy. What's up?
Hey, oh, this is an inconvenient time, Lays.
What? Lays. Are you busy?
Oh, no. What does Lays have to say? Where are the food at, yo?
Okay.
Okay, well, now that we're done, what the fuck? Okay.
Again, I'm loading a mighty Miitomo right now.
Okay. I just skipped your question, Lays.
Oh, thanks.
Okay, let me show off like one of my questions or something. Okay. I don't want to take up too much time.
I think I saw one of them.
What do you have even?
Here's a good one.
He has Hitler.
There's my me. Choice.
Hey.
What?
Oh wait, what's the question?
What do you think Lay spends most of his time doing?
Oh no.
I answered, wishing he was as hot as me.
Yeah.
I mean, hey, that's not I put in
like the worst possible answers I could think of these. This one.
Oh, I can call my guy back. Hey, look at my guy. You see my guy in there?
Oh, he's gone.
I'm taking him back home with me.
Are you tired, Nightclub?
Oh, no. Hey, like, I got the same thing, kinda.
You gonna fall asleep?
No.
Oh, wow.
Not yet, at least.
I bet you he painted that picture too, didn't he?
Hitler's so happy. That's him after he actually
thinking about
got...
you.
That
thinking about Hitler.
That's Hitler after Auschwitz.
I was gonna say that was Hitler if he actually
got
to art school.
Oh, look at that. He was over at Ultrox's.
Yeah.
If he got to art school, he probably had this glorious huge mustache.
Yeah.
Oh. What book made you laugh the most? Mein Kampf.
Oh my god.
Mein Kampf.
This guy playfully anti-Semitic. You realize that, don't you? Hold on, I have some old Russian money. have old Russian money.
Old Russian money.
One of my ancestors is Russian.
How do you act around people you're interested in? Buddy.
This here. This is mine now. No. It's mine now. You don't have a choice.
Give it to him!
What's something you've noticed becoming really popular lately? This is a reference. Incestuous gay porn.
I'm curious about that, but this is
you know. References!
Oh, it's right, never mind.
Alright, yeah. We should probably stop messing around with Mitomo. Alright.
So, at some point in your podcast, y'all get like sidetracked doing something else.
Yeah. Alright.
Let's kick this off.
Alright. So, we can end this one of many ways.
Alright.
However, I think it's best we end it on the fanfiction I wrote about the two people in the group.
Wrote a fanfiction.
Is everyone that we need
this. Where is it? Where, link it.
Everyone that's in it is here right now, yeah.
Link it. Come on.
I'm not going to link it. Oh, I guess I have to. All right, I'll link it.
I don't want to link it.
Well, how are we going to do this?
All right, I'm going to put it up. Okay, I'm going to put... Okay, listen, we need to organize the roles. We need narrator, we need Ultrox to do his part, and we need Dreadcore to do his part.
I'll be narrator!
All right, so... Here's no one skip ahead, you know. Let's not do that.
No skipping ahead.
All right, yeah.
What if you reverse roll as Dreadcore? All
right, so we got this right here. It's a lot. All right. It's about half as long as the one that we did before with the Anakin one.
Wait, how do you know which is who? What?
All right, you'll know. It's context clues. Context clues.
Context clues.
All right, no, so they were doing something else.
Okay.
All right. So here's how it starts.
Now they're reading fan fiction.
All right. It's called Ultrox's Dream by the Lay's Boy.
Oh my god.
And here. All right. Now. All right. Ultrox, you play yourself. Dreadcore plays himself. And we're gonna need some narrators. So if you want to rotate, maybe.
I'll be the narrator.
This is gonna be great.
You know what? We can have one dedicated narrator.
I will take the burden of doing such a thing.
Wow. Thank you. You're a kind soul. Good Samaritan. This is all right. So
great.
Let's go ahead and start. Ultrox, take it away. You just take, like, what's not in quotations, pretty much.
I bet Jake is real happy he's not in this podcast. this is my part. I say this all the time. Like, it's unless you want to read the title and stuff.
I already did.
Already did.
And Lay's already did it.
Let's do this professionally. Ultrox's Dream by the Lay's Boy.
Hey guys, if I could rearrange the alphabet, I would put you and I together.
Those words echoed through Ultrox's head before every recording session. They mean more to him than just a shitty pickup. The cold touch of Ultrox's hands upon Dreadcore's bare chest.
That's you.
I can only imagine the possibilities.
Okay.
Ultrox finished an Orcs Must Die 2 game with Dreadcore. Dreadcore says after giving the finishing blow to the final wave,
"Yeah, we did it! We won, Ultrox!"
Ultrox could hear the happiness behind Dreadcore's voice.
This is Ultrox.
"Yeah, we did it! I could literally kiss you right now!"
Said heat of the moment, not realizing the levels of awkwardness he brought on. Dreadcore acts sheepish, and is a little put off by this random comment.
Okay then, Ultrox. Yeah, look at the time. I think I'm gonna go to sleep now.
Yeah, sure, man. I'll talk to you tomorrow. Good night.
Ultrox hangs up as Dreadcore awkwardly says his goodbye. Ultrox says to himself,
"Oh, fuck, how could I be so stupid to say that? I know he's not into guys, Where is it? I don't have the $10,000 he wants before he has sex with a guy."
Ultrox sighs as he is disappointed. He will never have. he will never have personal time with Dreadcore.
I'm not gonna go to bed. Fuck my life.
Ultrox heads to bed, thinking about his sudden outburst.
Oh, I am gonna go to bed. Sorry, I fucked it up.
Yeah, it's the whole part of the story, man. It's real crucial to the plot.
I'll do it over. I'm gonna go to bed. Fuck my life.
Ultrox, wake up!
Ultrox opens his eyes as he notices the glowing face of Dreadcore, and all muscular body on top of him.
Why, hello there, handsome.
Dreadcore wakes as Ultrox starts to comprehend what's going on.
Oh, I get it. What the fuck is going on? Where am I?
Ultrox screams in his confusion.
You're in my sweet embrace now, you West Coast hunk.
What? Dreadcore likes his lips as he licks his lips as he finishes introducing Ultrox to his own dream.
Let me do the work and I'll let you get all the pleasure.
A final wink from Dreadcore before he commences the fun.
That's commences. Okay, proofread this.
Ultrox is still confused as hell. Dreadcore slowly runs his hands downward on Ultrox's naked torso. Oh, he's shirtless now. Ultrox has slight resistance at first, but comes into terms with the situation. Dreadcore takes his time to keep his hands as he grazes Ultrox's body slowly, sensually.
I'm gonna have a good time with you, Ultrox.
Says Dreadcore as he finally trapples Ultrox's pants zipper. Dreadcore takes his left hand to the zipper as he unzips Ultrox's private place while maintaining contact with Ultrox's chest with his right hand. Dreadcore shoots a glance and a smile to Ultrox as he looks at his cock. Ultrox shivers as Dreadcore takes his cool lips to the tip of his penis. Ultrox's face in body language says it all. And he wants it, Dreadcore.
This me?
yeah.
Nightclub, I think you,
Well, actually, yeah, it still goes on to the next line there, when Dreadcore slowly licks.
I think Nightclub cut out, because I can't... He was moving his mouth, I couldn't hear anything.
Yeah. Nightclub, I think you muted your mic. Yeah, he definitely did.
Yeah, no, there's nothing there.
Thank God.
I think we all needed a break from that for a second.
Okay.
Let's start. Hey, hello?
Right, we hear you now, It's getting hot here.
Where did I cut off?
Dreadcore slowly licks. Yeah.
Hey, good! Anyways.
Got a bookmarked.
Dreadcore slowly licks his shaft as he slowly takes his grasp hold of his dick up and down. Ultrox moans a little as he just wants Dreadcore to get him. Submerge himself on his penis.
What?
Dreadcore gives in to Ultrox's wishes and opens his mouth big enough for Ultrox's monster cock.
It's a fiction, as you see.
Pretty accurate.
Oh. Ultrox feels Dreadcore's tongue as he swirls it around his veiny shaft.
I'm done eating.
One moves slowly until he decides when to speed it up. Dreadcore's in full control of Ultrox's fucking war! Oh god. Ultrox is alive now!
Oh, Dread. Oh my god. I need this so bad. Please don't stop, I beg you. What
Ultrox
the fuck?
Says as his breath escapes him from the excitement. Dreadcore continues sucking until Ultrox signals he's about to climax.
This is just Corp.
Nanda, I want you to.
Oh my
god.
Says Dreadcore as he stops his pleasing fellatio. Dreadcore decides to give Ultrox some time to calm down and steps away to unbuckle his pants. He shimmies his sweatpants down his ginger hairy legs. Ultrox sees this and struggles to gain some freedom from his restraints. Wait, he's restrained?
Yeah.
This is a dream. It doesn't need to make sense.
It just keeps going as it goes along, you know.
And the restraints magically get tighter. Okay. Dreadco returns, pantsless, and slowly approaching Ultrox with intent to straddle. Suddenly, faint alarm can be heard. Ultrox blinks and wakes in his bed, now realizing he was dreaming the entire fantasy.
Oh no.
Ultrox looks under the covers at his raging boner and his favorite dream before he forgets. His last memory is exhausted into a Kleenex.
The end. Look at that. How about that?
So basically, Ultrox got off bad here. Dreadcore's okay. He was fantasy Dreadcore.
Dreadcore was mentally violated.
Lays, did you say you wrote this?
I did.
Is this a true story?
Yeah. Is it a true story?
Is it?
Lays, what the fuck is that?
You read art.
I'm thinking about my cousin's penis!
That's true.
You said you would read it.
Tim, fanfiction that often?
He didn't say fanfiction. He did say Ultrox. Oh, wow, say Dreadcore. Those things are all said.
Oh, yeah.
You know what? Go. Fly a kite.
I think this has gone too far.
Hold on.
I think I'm gonna have to file a complaint.
Blaze, can we go up there and change it all to his real name?
We gotta call HR.
Change it all to Ultrox's real name.
I don't even know his real name.
I think Nightclub slipped up and said Brandon earlier.
Brandon?
Yeah, sure. That's it.
Rusty Shackleford is his real name.
Rusty Shackleford, there we go.
There you go. That's his name right there.
Change it all to Brandon so it won't be so uncomfortable for me. Oh, that was fun, I think.
Okay.
Sure!
That was all fun.
Yeah.
That was definitely interesting. I unbuckled my pants and then pulled down my sweatpants.
Yeah. Oh, that's true. I didn't think about that. I was just kind of like, alright, this sounds good. Let's write this.
You're wearing a belt in your sweatpants?
Hey, you know, sweatpants are too loose. Okay.
This is Top Koala. You need to challenge someone else to write a fan fiction.
Oh god!
Oh yeah, I'm fighting Dreadcore now, aren't I? That's right.
Dreadcore's the on top koala.
I'm the on top koala. I'm two top koalas so far.
Man. Well, I'm talking about you on top of me, but I'm Leo.
Oh, also that.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, actually, I never actually get on top of you.
A little squirrel thing, like raw, like in Smite. You know? Have you ever seen that?
I'm the power bottom.
Was that part cut out of the video? Let's see.
I feel sick.
All right, man. Should I write another one?
No.
Literally, Dreadcore. Dreadcore, that should be our Blazing Koala challenge.
No.
Come on. That's
a terrible idea.
Never.
Who,
no.
Who writes? Which one do you write the better fan fiction?
No.
Write a new fan fiction, but don't make it about me and Dreadcore.
Okay. Well, I can't just use it. It's been too soon. I gotta make a new one. Like maybe Cody. And
yeah, take a couple of weeks off, then come back to the storyline.
Kind of take some weeks off, you know.
You can take 2 years off if you want to. It's cool. It's exhausting work, you know.
Yeah, a few decades, perhaps.
You know, me and Dreadcore aren't going to be able to play together ever again. It's too uncomfortable now.
Oh, no, I ruined the friendship.
I bet it is too uncomfortable now with the truth out there.
Yeah.
Truth.
The truth is out there now. Now we know.
Investigate 11.
Man. Well.
Aren't they making the X-Files remake?
Nope, that's it. Goodbye.
All right.
Bye, guys.
Bye. Yep.
Good night. Dream of Dreadcore.
Is there someone behind him?
They're in the tall grass.
Kill the dude.
To your right, I'll talk.
I'm a baloney.
Okay, there's that guy.
I think it was against the snark.
There's one more. No, two more.
Jesus. Oh, it's a geyser.
I'm gonna be back in a minute.
See, I go jack off right now to get the, you know, just so excited.
You're in my sweet embrace now, you West Coast hunk.
That was a good life. Oh, I like how the let's see, the first few lines were actual lines we've used before. Obviously, if I could rearrange the alphabet and put UI together, that was
That was creative. I mean, we have played Orcs Must Die 2, but we're never gonna play it ever again. But.
I'm pretty sure you said I can only imagine the possibilities at some point before, just not about my chess.
What? Yeah, we need to make a fanfiction just from direct quotes.
Yeah.
Well, I gotta say, and also the Utrox thing. You call me Utrox a lot.
I'm not actually sure if you might have said I could literally kiss you right now at the end of Orcs Must Die 2. I'm not entirely sure.
Did he really say that?
I don't know. It's possible. I mean, it's probably jokingly, but it's possible that's something he said.